You know, it's not every day you get to introduce a new football coach for your Division I football program, and especially not after a historic run through the playoffs for this Black Bear program, and it's something very exciting.
Nick Charlton took an unconventional path to become the head coach of the University of Maine. But from an early age, football was in his blood, and it would end up taking him to Orno, Maine to be the 36th head coach of the Black Bears.
You know, I played basketball, baseball, football when I was growing up. I grew up in Salem, Mass. I played quarterback in high school. So I always liked, I like competition. I like, my whole family played sports. My dad played in college, my brothers played. So we kind of grew up on that. And, getting into coaching was something that I had thought about, throughughout really when I was younger, going into high school and then going into college, but I always wanted to be a politician. That's what I thought I was gonna do.
When it came time for Nick to choose a college, Charlton made the difficult decision to give up football to pursue a philosophy degree at Boston College. But it quickly became apparent that something was missing in Nick's life.
It was only about a month, so that was pretty quick. At the time, I think I just knew something was missing, so I was trying to figure out what that was. I think I knew what it was. It was always, coaching and leadership are things that I've always been very interested in, and it was a matter of telling myself that it was, a good profession that would impact people, I think, ultimately.
From there, Nick developed a relationship with former Boston College defensive backs coach and recruiting coordinator Mike Saravo, and his path to becoming a head football coach began to take shape. He joined the coaching staff as a student assistant, and then upon his graduation, continued as a graduate assistant under Steve Adazio, trying to soak up as much as he could along the way.
I remember just working with some guys that taught me a lot, and I mean, I learned the most football I've ever learned. And you just see how guys do things, whether you like them or you don't, and you just try to take that as you go. When I say you're always the head coach of your position, you should be the head coach of your position. When I was running a scout team, I was the head coach of the scout team. When I was in the recruiting department, I wanted those mailings to be the best they could possibly be. And I know it sounds stupid, but I really believe you do one thing one way, you do it the same way everywhere.
After 3 years at Boston College, Nick joined the Maine coaching staff as a receivers coach, beginning his rapid rise through the ranks. In 2016, he was the special teams coordinator and then named the offensive coordinator in 2018. A short 9 months later, Nick Charlton was named the head coach of the University of Maine Black Bears at the age of 30, becoming the youngest head coach in college football.
Nick has an incredible way of connecting with this particular age group. You could see it in a year I get to spend with him as the coordinator. The students really respond to him. He knows what makes them tick. He knows what gets them frustrated. He knows what gets them motivated. And you knew right away that the students were going to be able to adapt to his style very quickly, and that he was going to be a good mentor and coach going forward.
For Maine, young coaches aren't anything new for the program. Charlton takes over for Joe Harris-Simiak, who was also only 30 years old when he got his first head coaching opportunity at the University of Maine.
You take a look at all of our coaches, and we're young across the board. And I think it helps us here at Maine. Because of the type of student we're attracting, because of the type of environment we have, I think it's a huge advantage for us.
And that advantage can be seen instantly with the connection Nick has with his players.
He's hardworking. Like I said, he's funny. He really does like to have a good time and enjoy what we're doing, because, football's a game. It's a sport, it's his life, it's our lives right now, but, you gotta learn how to have fun with it. He knows how to connect to the younger guys, and I think that's important in our culture and in our program, and he's got a really good relationship with everybody, so he can kind of bring that in all aspects, and, it's not just coach players, We really are close and we're a family.
After taking over a program that won the CAA title and made a trip to the FCS semifinals, Coach Charlton's philosophy to build on that success is simple.
Coach them hard, love them hard. That's it. I think you got to coach guys hard. I believe in that. But if they don't know that you care about them, it doesn't go the other way. So I think that's important.
You need your head coach to be one of the hardest workers, because then that'll trickle down. Your leader's got to work hard. If you ask our captains, they'll say the same thing. If you want everybody else to work hard, you want everybody else to put the same amount of work in, you got to do it yourself. You got to lead by example. So I think that's the biggest thing.
those relationships that Coach Charlton has formed and the moments that he shared with the people he met through coaching football has filled that hole Nick found when he gave up playing football to go to Boston College. And that's what makes coaching so special and a natural fit for Nick Charlton.
It's got to be the relationships and on the staff and with the players. I mean, it's a grind, and Division I football is a job for everybody. And so I think going through that and that experience, you know, the highs and the lows, when you get a chance at those highs, it's really, really cool. And not a lot of people get to do that in a lot of ways. So I think when you build those relationships and you have those experiences and then you get to experience those things, I mean, it's extremely meaningful, like in your life. And I think that stuff's important.